video, we are going to discuss about DHCP protocol, dynamic host configuration protocol. So first of all, why we need DHCP in the network? Okay. So we all know that whenever we want to access any network resources like client server, mail server, web server, or DNS server, so we require an IP address on the endpoint. If the endpoint does not have any IP address, then it will not be able to initiate the traffic for any IP services. So this is the essential thing for any endpoint to have an IP address. Now we can assign IP address statically. We have two methods: static IP address assignment and dynamic IP address assignment. Dynamic. In static, we configure IP address manually on the network interface card or on the network adapter of the endpoint. In DHCP, or you can say when you are going to configure IP address dynamically, then we use DHCP protocol. Mostly in your LAN segment, we use DHCP protocol to dynamically assign IP addresses on the endpoint. So this is the basic requirement for DHCP, why we are using DHCP in the network. After that, if I talk about DHCP, you know that it stands for Dynamic Host Configuration Protocol. Okay. And it is used to assign IP addresses on the endpoints automatically. It is used to assign IP address on the endpoints automatically. Okay. On the endpoints automatically. It is a network management protocol, okay, used to configure IP address, subnet mask, default gateway, DNS server information, okay, net BIOS server information, and many other attributes on the endpoint dynamically or automatically. Okay, and when this IP address and other information will be configured on the endpoints automatically, then endpoints will be able to communicate with the network, or they will be able to access any services hosted in the network like mail server, file services, web services, okay, any services which are required for endpoint. Now DHCP, it works at layer 4, or you can say it uses UDP for its communication or to exchange DHCP packets. Now in DHCP, it is a server client protocol. It is a server client protocol. It means there will be a client which will send, you can say, which will try to get an IP address from DHCP server. It is a server client protocol. There will be a device which will be configured as DHCP client, and there will be a device like a server where we configure DHCP service or DHCP server to provide IP address and other parameters automatically. Okay. So here it uses two port numbers for UDP. Because it is a server client protocol, here it uses two port numbers in UDP, because it is a classless protocol which will not initiate any connection before sending DHCP packets. So if I talk about the port numbers, client uses UDP 68 as the source port number to send the request, and 67 or UDP 67 is used as the destination port number for DHCP server. For DHCP server. Okay. So this is how DHCP will be working in the network. It will use UDP for its communication. It is based on BOOTP protocol. It is bootstrap protocol. BOOTP protocol. Okay. So here, whenever any client will try to get an IP address, it will send some packets to DHCP server. It will send some request to DHCP server to get an IP address. Okay. So overall, DHCP will simplify IP address management in the network. Okay. It will also take care about the least time, because whenever DHCP server will assign any IP address to the endpoint, it will also give some least time. Some amount of period will be defined for which the client can have that IP address. After that, IP address will be, you can say, renewed, or it can be released. Means whenever client, or you can say the IP address lease is going to expire, then client has to renew the IP address. And if the lease is expired, then client will not be able to use that IP address. Okay. Clear. Now here we have some components of DHCP server, or DHCP components of DHCP. Not only server. So here we have a DHCP server which will be used in the network. We need to configure DHCP server. We need to configure DHCP client. Okay. We need to define IP address pool. It is also a component which will be used in DHCP server configuration. After that, we need to define lease time for the addresses, lease, okay, and DHCP relay. DHCP relay. These are the components which will be used. Now you know that DHCP server, it is a network device running DHCP service that holds IP addresses and related configuration information. Okay, like whenever you are going to, or your client is trying to get an IP address, it will send the request to DHCP server. So DHCP server contains, or it holds IP address or IP addresses and other information like subnet mask, what will be the default gateway. So all this configuration will be done on DHCP server. Okay. So it can be any server, like Microsoft servers are there, or you can also configure a router or firewall or a switch as a DHCP server. Okay. After this, we have DHCP client. Clients are the endpoint that receives configuration from DHCP server, configuration information from DHCP server. So whenever any computer, any endpoint, any desktop, laptop, IP phone, or network printer, and many other network devices, mobile devices, whenever they require any IP address, then they will send some requests, some packets to DHCP server, and these devices are called DHCP client. Okay. There are many IoT endpoints and many other devices in the network which will require an IP address. So whenever we need IP address and we want to assign it dynamically, then we have to use DHCP. In that case, that endpoint, that particular device who is requesting for the IP address, it will be considered as DHCP client. After that, we have IP address pool. IP address pool is the range of addresses that are available for DHCP client. Okay, like on DHCP server, we need to define the subnet, the network which we want to use in our, you can say, in our network to connect, to provide connectivity. Okay, so on the DHCP server, we need to define IP address pool. That pool will contain a range of addresses which can be provided to the user whenever any endpoint will send the request to get an IP addresses. Okay. After that, we have lease time. Lease is the length of time for which a DHCP client can hold the IP address information. Okay. When a lease expires, client must renew the lease. Otherwise, client will not be able to use that IP address. Okay. It will be released. It will be, you can say, released from the endpoint. After that, we have DHCP relay. This DHCP relay concept will be used when your DHCP server is connected in different network. Let's say, for example, here we have a router connected, R1. With this router, there is a switch connected. And with this switch, I am connecting my endpoint. Now, if I am configuring this router as a DHCP server, okay, and all these users are in VLAN 1, for example, or they are in same VLAN. So whenever we require IP addresses on the endpoints, we will use DHCP server, right? And in this case, DHCP server exists in the same broadcast domain, in the same network. So they will get the IP address directly, right? There will be no use of relay agent. But when we configure DHCP server in a different broadcast domain, in a different network, for example, with R1, there is a router connected R2. And on this router, I am configuring DHCP server. Means I am defining pool and all other configuration for the DHCP perspective. Now, when these endpoints will require an IP address, they will send broadcast packets, right? So here we need a device, a host, you can say, that listens for these broadcast messages from the client and forward them to DHCP server. This is your relay agent. It will be configured as relay agent. So relay agent will be used when DHCP server is configured in different network, because within the network here it will generate the broadcast request. If the DHCP server is connected in different network, then this broadcast will not be forwarded, right? So we have to use a relay agent so that it can convert this broadcast request to unicast. Here between this endpoint and this relay agent, communication will be broadcast like this as it happens, and after that this unicast communication will happen between relay agent and DHCP server. So this relay agent will convert broadcast messages into unicast so that it can send DHCP messages to DHCP server. Okay, so we will configure this one also. So these are the components of DHCP server which will be used in the network. Now, if I talk about the benefit of DHCP using in the network, here you can say that it will provide accurate IP addresses in the network, right? There will be very less error in IP address assignment, okay? It will also reduce IP address conflict. Mostly when we manually assign the IP address, then we can assign same IP address on two endpoints. At that time, conflict will occur. But if we are using DHCP server in the network to assign IP addresses, then there will be very less chances for IP address conflict, you can say. And here we are also automating IP address administration, right? We are automatically providing the IP address to the endpoint, so endpoint doesn't need any kind of configuration to get the IP address from DHCP server. Only it should be configured to get an IP address from DHCP server, nothing more than that. Okay. Clear. So these are the components that we are going to discuss and we are going to configure in DHCP. After that, if I talk about the communication between client and server, how it will happen to get an IP address. Let's say, for example, this is an endpoint and here it is connected with a switch. And this is my router, which is configured as DHCP server. So right now this DHCP server is configured in same broadcast domain. Okay, it is configured in same broadcast domain. So how this DHCP process will be started? As soon as this PC will boot up, it will require an IP address. So how it will discover its DHCP server? It will send a DHCP discover message. Okay. It will send a DHCP discover message. Okay. After that, see, this discover message is used to discover DHCP server in local broadcast domain, because this DHCP discover message is a broadcast request. It cannot go out of this broadcast domain. Okay, so this discover message will be used to discover the DHCP server in local broadcast domain. After that, if there is any DHCP server exist in local broadcast domain, then it will reply or it will send DHCP offer message. I will explain all these packets. Offer message, okay. This offer message will be sent to the endpoint with an offered IP address. Okay. In this message, DHCP server will offer an IP address to the endpoint. And then if endpoint is If endpoint wants to get an IP address, then it will send DHCP request message to the DHCP server. At the end, DHCP will send DHCP acknowledgement, and that IP address will be assigned to the endpoint acknowledgement. This is called a DORA process. This process is called DORA process. Here, 4 packets will be exchanged between DHCP server and client. Client will initiate for DHCP process so that it can get an IP address, and after that, server will reply with offer message. Okay. So here we have these 4 messages. Other than these 4 messages, we have some messages as well. Like we have negative acknowledgement, we have inform message, DHCP release message, and renew message. But for now, these 4 packets will be exchanged initially to get an IP address. Okay. To get an IP address, discover, offer, request, and acknowledgement. So if I talk about discover message, when we start the device, let me tell you about DHCP packets. And this is DHCP discover message. Okay. So when we start the device, it checks whether a valid IP configuration is available on the network adapter or not. If the valid IP configuration is not available, the device will send DHCP discover message and broadcast this message on the local LAN segment. Okay. When we start the device, it will check, or you can say it will check whether a valid IP configuration is available or not. On the network adapter. If IP configuration is not available and client is configured to get an IP address, via DHCP, then it sends or it generates DHCP discover message. DHCP discover message and broadcasts it on the local LAN segment. On the local LAN segment. Now at this point, client does not have any IP address. Okay. So in discover message, source IP address from the endpoint will be 0.0.0. And it is a broadcast request, so destination IP address will be 255.255.255. It is a broadcast IP address. This will be the source IP address in DHCP discover message because client does not have any IP address. Okay. And destination IP address will be 255.255.255.255 because client is not aware about DHCP server. What is the IP address of DHCP server? Initially, it is starting the process, so it will try to discover DHCP server in local subnet. So it will send this broadcast message, discover message in the local segment. Okay. Now, after this, if DHCP server is available in local segment, local subnet, then DHCP server will send offer message. Okay. We have DHCP offer message. This is second message which will be used in DHCP communication. Offer message. See, since the client sends DHCP discover message to the local subnet broadcast, okay, or to the local subnet broadcast address, if a DHCP server is configured on the local network, it will also receive that broadcast message, okay, and it will reply with DHCP offer message. Okay. So client has sent DHCP discover message. If here I can start it, since the client, you can write it like this, has sent DHCP discover message in local subnet, in local subnet. So if a DHCP server exists in local broadcast domain, then it will reply with DHCP offer message. Okay, it will reply with DHCP offer message. So right now client does not have any IP address, right? And DHCP server cannot send DHCP offer message directly to the client. Because of this, server sets the destination address as a broadcast address, 255.255.255. Okay. So in other words, you can say server also broadcasts the DHCP message to the local network. It will broadcast offer message in local subnet. So destination IP address will be 255.255.255.255. If there is any client who does not, you can say, who cannot receive DHCP broadcast message, then DHCP broadcast bit will be removed, you can say. Then DHCP packets will come as unicast. Like in different, if I talk about Cisco, then all the packets will be broadcast. DHCP discover message, offer message, request message, and acknowledgement message, or the all the packets will be broadcast. Okay, and if I talk about other vendor communication, then it will be, let's say this is discover, offer, request, acknowledgement. If you are using Cisco devices, like in Cisco, all the packets will be broadcast. Okay. And if you are using other vendor devices, other vendor, then it will be broadcast, unicast, broadcast, and unicast. It depends on the broadcast bit, which is defined in DHCP header. Okay. So as per the broadcast bit, your DHCP message will be sent, but mostly it will be a broadcast message. Okay. DHCP offer message will be a broadcast message in the local subnet. Now this offer message contains offered IP address. Okay, this offer message contains protocol specific information and an IP configuration. Okay, it includes IP address, it includes subnet mask. So it will send this offer message to the client. Okay, in offer message, DHCP server sends IP configuration like IP address, subnet mask, gateway, DNS information, okay, DNS server, IP. You can also send domain name, host name, TFTP server, IP address, okay. Domain name. So all the requested parameters will be offered. Here it is sending the offer message. When this client will receive offer message, Okay, when this client will receive offer message, it will send request, DHCP request message. DHCP request message. So client has received offer message, okay. Client has received offer message. Now it is going to send request message. Now it is sending the request message for the offered parameters, okay. That okay, I am, you can say, I am willing to get this information, you can say. So this offer message will be sent from client to the server. It will also be a broadcast message, because till now the client does not have any IP address assigned, okay. So it will send the packet with the source IP address 0.0.0 and the destination will be broadcast IP address, okay. This is request packet, okay. Here this offer message, or you can say before client sends the request, DHCP offer message will be sent by the server. In the DHCP offer message, server includes host MAC address in a parameter known as client identifier. Okay. When host receives the DHCP offer message, then it checks that client identifier field in the message. If a host sees its own MAC address in that field, then it will accept that offer message. Okay. If any host finds his own MAC address on in the field, or you can say in the client identifier field, then host knows that the message is meant for it only, right? So it will accept that offer message. After that, it will generate request message depending on the number of, you can say, parameters that have been requested. It will send the DHCP request message. So after receiving DHCP offer message, client checks for DHCP client identifier. If it includes MAC address of the endpoint, then it will accept that offer and it will send DHCP request message. DHCP request message to request for all the offered parameters. All the offered parameters. Okay. Now when the DHCP server receives DHCP request message from the client, okay, the DHCP server will send acknowledgement message, DHCP acknowledgement message to the client. Okay, DHCP acknowledgement message is just an acknowledgement to the client indicating that the DHCP server has received request message of the client and the client can use the offered IP configuration. Okay, this is DHCP acknowledgement packet. Okay, DHCP acknowledgement packet. So here we can write it like this: when DHCP server receives request message from the client, when DHCP server receives request message from the client, it will send DHCP acknowledgement. It will send DHCP acknowledgement. Okay. This is an acknowledgement. To the client indicating that the DHCP server has received request message and the client can use offered IP configuration. Can use offered IP configuration. Okay. In some cases, the DHCP server may also respond with DHCP NAC, negative acknowledgement message. Okay, so this negative acknowledgement message tells the client that the offer is no longer valid and the client needs to send request message for the IP configuration again. Okay, clear. So these are the four packets which will be exchanged between DHCP server and client to complete DHCP operation. Okay. And after completing this acknowledgement, if it is successfully getting the acknowledgement, if the client is successfully getting the acknowledgement, it will be assigned with all the IP configuration which was sent from DHCP server. Okay. We will see this, how to configure all these things. And here we don't need to use any DHCP relay agent, because here this DHCP server is connected in local broadcast domain, in same broadcast domain. When any DHCP server is configured in different broadcast domain, in different network, then we need this DHCP relay agent. Okay, then we need this DHCP relay agent. Now let's configure this. Here I will use a Cisco router to configure as a DHCP server, and there will be some computers on which we will get an IP address from the DHCP server. Okay, so let's go to the lab and let's start these devices. Here we have two switches, one router and some endpoints connected with the switches. And this is your router. For now, I will configure R1 as a DHCP server. And these clients will get the IP address from this DHCP server. Okay. And they are in same broadcast domain, you can say. The addresses are in same broadcast domain. You can say these hosts or these computers will be assigned in same broadcast domain. And we will use 10.1.1.0/24 network in this LAN segment. Okay. And this is router 1 connected. Here we have only on the switches, we have only VLAN 1 configured. And you know that by default, all the interfaces are assigned in VLAN 1. Okay. Let's take the console access. So on switches, we don't need to do anything. Okay. By default, they are all in VLAN 1. If you are using different VLAN communication, then you have to configure this inter-switch link as the trunk port, and you have to assign these endpoints into their specific VLAN. But for now, I am using VLAN 1 link. Here you can check show VLAN brief. All these interfaces are assigned in VLAN 1. And on switch 2, here also show VLAN brief. Here also all these interfaces are assigned in VLAN 1. Okay. After this, here I will configure this router as a DHCP server. Let's take the access of router. And these are virtual PCs I have connected here. These PCs. Let me start them. We will use these PCs as DHCP client, and this router 1 is DHCP server. Right now it is connected in local broadcast domain. Okay, we will use this DHCP server later when we will configure DHCP relay agent, and this DHCP server is connected in different broadcast domain. Okay, So we will configure DHCP relay agent at that time. But for now, we just need to configure this router as a DHCP server. And on these PCs, we will request IP address dynamically. So this is router one. Enable. Let's go to global configuration mode. Here, let's give host name R1. Now, with R1, this LAN segment is connected. It is interface E0x0. So let's assign IP address on this interface. I will configure 10.1.1.10/24 on this router. Now we need to configure a DHCP pool for this network 10.1.1.0 because we will assign 10.1.1.0/24 network IP address on these PCs, okay, on these desktops. So to configure DHCP server on a router, you need to configure DHCP pool or IP address pool. So here you will run IP DHCP pool. And you need to give a name for this pool. You can give any name, like if you are using some identical names like HR pool, sales pools, it's up to you. Otherwise, you can give the name according to your VLAN also. Like I am using VLAN 1 only and all the endpoints are assigned in VLAN 1. So I will create a DHCP pool with the name VLAN 1. You can use any name here. It is just a tag, just a name to uniquely identify the pool. Okay. After this, here you will configure network. Which network you want to use, network number in dotted decimal notation. So here I can give 10.1.1.0/24. Other than this, you can put subnet mask. If you are not using /24 or /CID or value, you can use subnet mask also. You have to give a space here, like this, 10.1.1.0/24. And then default router. This default router is used to define default gateway for these endpoints, for these PCs. Okay, so for these endpoints, gateway will be this router interface, router E0x0 interface IP address. So I will configure this 10.1.1.10. This is the basic requirement that you need to fulfill always. You have to define a network subnet which will be used to assign IP addresses. In this subnet, we have 254 usable hosts, right? And from this, I have assigned one address on my router's interface. Other than this, you can put DNS server information, DNS server IP address, let's say global DNS 8.8.8. You can push domain name, for example, nc.local. You can provide lease time also. Okay, here you can define infinite lease time when you don't want that this lease should expire for the endpoint or endpoint should get that IP address forever. Okay, if you want to define lease time, you can define it in days. Here, let's say I'm giving it for 7 days. Okay, so lease 7. Now you can exit from here and you can check the running configuration for DHCP. Here it will show you that this is your pool name. Then this network address will be used to assign IP addresses to the connected endpoints. After that, it is default router, default gateway for the endpoints 10.1.1.10. It will be your router's interface IP address, E0x0 interface IP address. Then DNS 8.8.8, then domain name nc.local, lease time. Okay, so all this information can be provided. Other than this information, we can also use DHCP options. DHCP options. This DHCP option is a field in DHCP header to provide some other IP configuration to the endpoint. Let's say if I want to push WLC IP address to access point. Okay. We use access point in the network and we want to provide WLC IP address to access point. Then we use option 150. Okay, this is a DHCP option number. When we provide subnet mask, when we provide host name, for each and every parameter which is being provided, there is a DHCP option defined. Okay, so this DHCP option will be used to provide some other IP configuration like TFTP server IP configuration. TFTP server IP. Okay. In case of IP phone, we provide call manager IP address using DHCP option 43.
So these addresses will be used to provide IP address, okay, or you can say specific IP addresses to the endpoint, to the requesting endpoint. So options is a separate field which will be used to provide some specific parameters to the endpoint, okay.
So this is our topology.
Here DHCP server is configured. Now you need to take care about one thing, that whenever you are configuring DHCP server, you need to take care about the used IP addresses from the pool, because we don't want to provide these IP addresses to any endpoint, otherwise conflict can occur, right? Because this IP address is configured on the gateway interface, on the router's interface, so we are not assigning this IP address to any of the connected host, otherwise IP conflict can happen, okay? So here we can exclude these addresses, IP DHCP excluded address 10.1.1.10. Means from this pool, this 10.1.1.10 address will be excluded. It will not be assigned to any endpoint because it is already assigned as a gateway IP address. If you have any other device which is manually configured with the IP address and that IP address belongs to this network, then you can exclude that IP address also. This excluded address will be used to exclude any IP address from DHCP pool so that IP conflict should not occur. Okay. Because if you are using this IP address statically assigned on any endpoint or on any network interface of router, then you don't need to assign it to any other user, any other endpoint. Okay. Now DHCP server is configured. You can verify the configuration like this. After this, you need to go to the endpoints. Okay. So all of these PCs are connected in VLAN 1. And here I am using these virtual PCs. So you just need to check the IP configuration. Right now there is no IP and subnet mask DNS, right? There is no gateway configured. Now let's run IP DHCP, okay? And this PC will send the request DHCP discover message. You can see right now it is sending discover message. If DHCP server exists in local subnet, then it will send offer message, then request, and then acknowledgement. And here DORA process is completed. And this client has received an IP address 10.1.1/24 with gateway IP address 10.1.1.10. You can verify this configuration using show IP. Here you can check IP address and subnet mask, gateway IP address. This is DNS server IP address 8.8.8. It is provided by the DHCP server. After that, here we have DHCP server IP address. Who is your DHCP server actually? And this is lease time. Okay. We defined 7 days. Domain name nc.local. This is the MAC address of the endpoint. Okay. Clear. After that, you can go to PC2 and here you can configure IP DHCP. It is also sending discover message. Then request message, discover, then offer, then request, then acknowledgement. And this client has received an IP address 10.1.1.2. And the gateway IP address is 10.1.1.10. You can run show IP. Here it is getting this 10.1.1.2 IP and all the parameters which were requested. Okay. Now, if I want to get the IP address on PC3 and if I enable capture on this router, capture and E0/0, here it will show you all the 4 packets which will be used in DORA process. Okay. It is starting. Wait. Now let's go to PC3 and here if you check the IP address, show IP. There is no IP address and information assigned to this PC. Now I want to get the parameters via DHCP. So I will run this command IP DHCP. It will send a DHCP discover message. Then offer message will be sent by the server, request and acknowledgement. Right now DHCP server exists in local subnet only, local broadcast domain. So we are not using any DHCP relay agent. Here you can check these packets. Let me increase the font size. Let me zoom in. Okay, here you can search for DHCP and it will show you the packets. DHCP discover message was sent. See, right now I'm not using Cisco devices, right? So here you can check, you will find this discover offer request acknowledgement as broadcast, unicast, broadcast, unicast. If you are using Cisco devices, if you are requesting the IP address from Cisco, if you are requesting to get an IP address from Cisco device, then it will be all broadcast, broadcast, broadcast. Okay. Clear. You can open this packet. This is discover message. Source IP 000, destination IP 255.255.255.255. UDP port number, source port is 68, destination port is 67. And this is DHCP packet. Here you can check, these are the fields in DHCP header. I will explain these fields in our next video. Okay. This is DHCP message type. It is also an option, right? DHCP option 12 for host name. DHCP client identifier. In this client identifier, you will find the MAC address of the endpoint. Okay. And this is options field here. 50.255 options are there, but according to your requirement, you are going to use them. This is offer message. In offer, here it is showing you unicast, because right now this client does not support DHCP broadcast message to receive. Okay. That's why here you can check this DHCP broadcast bit. You can check boot p flags, and broadcast bit is not set. It is unicast. It is not set. Okay. That's why this packet is coming as unicast packet. If the broadcast bit is set in the offer message, then this offer message will also be the broadcast message. Right now it is unicast. And this is offered IP address 10.1.1.3. This is client MAC address. Okay. Message type offer. All this information is provided. This is DHCP server identifier. Okay. Other than this, here it will show you renewal time value. Okay. Subnet mask, default gateway IP address, DNS server, domain name. Whatever parameters we are providing to the user, they will all be offered via this message. This is your IP address, offered IP address. This is called YI IP address. Okay. So this was offer message. After that, here it is sending request. Again, it is broadcast. Okay. Request message is again broadcast. Here you will find it is requesting for the offered parameters. You can check, these are the offered parameters. And client is sending the request. This is parameter request list. Client requires all these parameters. Okay. So this is request message. In this request message, it is sending the request to get this IP address 10.1.1.10 to this DHCP server 10.1.1. Sorry, to get this IP address 10.1.1.3 to this DHCP server 10.1.1.10. Okay. This is request message. At the end, client will send at the end, server will send acknowledgement to the client, and the IP address will be assigned on the client. Client IP address is 10.1.1.3. And this is message type acknowledgement. All this information is assigned to the endpoint successfully. Okay. And here your DORA process completes, and client has received the IP address also. So always remember this thing, whenever you are using Cisco devices as the DHCP client and as the DHCP server, you will see all these packets will be broadcast. Okay. Discover, offer, request, acknowledgement. All the packets will be broadcast packets. But if you are using different vendor devices, then it will be broadcast, unicast. Okay. Because some of the devices does not support DHCP broadcast messages to receive. At that time, DHCP broadcast bit will not be set. It will be unicast. At that time, offer message will be unicast. If the broadcast bit is set, then offer message will be broadcast. Okay. It is like this. So this is how we can get an IP address. Let's go to PC4 also. And let's get an IP address on PC4. On this PC3, we have received 10.1.1.3. You can go to PC4. And here also you can run IP DHCP. Okay. And it will send discover message, client will send offer message, then client will send discover message, then server will send offer message, then client will send request message, then server will send acknowledgement, and client will be assigned with an IP address. Okay. And rest of the parameters of DHCP header, we will discuss in our next class. We will also discuss about DHCP relay agent. Okay. So thank you so much for watching the video.
Bye-bye.